Good morning, class. So we go ahead with our chapter industries. Now, up till now we were learning about the factors which are good for industrial locations. So first we learned about the geographical factors. Today we will take up the economic factors. So let us do a quick revision of the geographical factors. The first thing which is important is availability of raw materials, suitable climate, availability of land and accessible water sources. Now children, suitable climates we talked about. Let us first quickly go to availability of raw materials. I want you to turn to page number 37. Raw materials are the most basic and crucial need for any industry. Without any raw material, you cannot have a finished product or a good. So before that, we came to the factors which determine the location of industries. We learned about the need for industries, the different types of industries. We learned there are two types of, on the basis of raw material use, there are two types of industries, mineral based and agro based. Mineral based are ones which depend on the mining sector, and where different ores are excavated from deep inside the earth. Such minerals and fossil fuels are used in manufacturing processes such as iron ore, bauxite, limestone, coal, petroleum and natural gas. These are used. Then we learned about the agro-based industries, agro-based industries are industries which get their raw materials from the agricultural sector, are called agro-based industries. Now, agro-based industries can be large-scale, small-scale or cottage-level, whereas mineral-based industries are usually are large-scale industries or heavy industries. They are also known as heavy industries. Then we learned about the classification of industries based on the investment and size. They are large-scale, small-scale and cottage industries. Large scale industries are mostly iron and steel, textile, shipbuilding and automobile industries, and they require huge infrastructure, large workforce and have heavy capital investment. When we learnt about small scale industries, we learnt about those who do not require a huge infrastructure. They do not require space for a large space or a large workforce or a huge investment in the form of cash. Then we learned about cottage industries, which are mostly family run or they employ a least few number of labor or outside workforce. Now they are also known as handicrafts, and generally they are dealing in handlooms, khadi, toys, small tools. Then beekeeping, silk weaving, papad making, all these they come under cottage industries. Then we learnt about the factors which influence, geographical factors which determine the location of industries, availability of raw material. So wherever the raw material is easily available, industrialists make sure that the mills are located close by. If sugar mills are located far away from sugarcane fields, then the time taken for the sugar canes to reach the factory will undermine its quality as the sugar cane begins to dry up. So there is a limited period of time in which the sugar canes have to reach these sugar mills for the extraction process. Then we talked about the suitable climate. Extreme climate is not good, too hot or too humid or too cold. See, over here we talked about in this particular paragraph, they told us about that when we are talking about textile industry, then the cotton threads break in dry climate, so it needs a little bit of humidity. So it is possible that you can install artificial humidifiers, but then the point is that it will increase the production cost, therefore increasing the cost of the goods as well. Then we learnt about the availability of land. See, if sufficient land is not available for setting up of large scale industries, then it is no use. From where the raw or ore is being extracted, then it is going to increase the production cost, as lot of money will be required for transportation of ore from the extraction unit to the processing unit. Then we talked about the accessible water source, that availability of abundant water supply is needed for most of the industries. Then we talked about these industries being water, like steel, chemical, rayon, paper and thermal power. Now today we will learn about the different economic factors which determine the location of an industry. Availability, I want you to open up to page number 38. Availability of natural factor is not enough for the setting up of industries. The process of manufacturing depends upon several human as well as human-made factors, collectively called as economic factors. So what are economic factors? Process of manufacturing involving several human as well as human-made factors is known as economic factors. To generate profit, these factors play very important roles. First is cheap labor. Cheap and abundant labor reduces the cost of production. That is why the industries opt to locate in populated areas. See children, where the supply of human labor is more, then of course they can hire such labor at low wages also. Otherwise, where population is sparse, then of course they are, when they are looking for human labor, then they'll have to give higher wages to attract people to their industrial units. For example, today China has been able to lower the production cost substantially due to its cheap and abundant labor supply. This is why Chinese products, they may not be very high in quality terms, but they are very cheap. What light consumer goods like mobile phones, computer hardware, watches, televisions, toys, home appliances, electronic equipment and agro-based industries, labor is an important factor. So not everything can a robot or a machine do when we are talking about such consumer articles or such consumer goods. Now a developed market. See, if the product which I am developing, if it does not have, there is no demand for that good, that there is no point in manufacturing that product. So a developed market has to be there. Developed market in the sense that the product which is coming out of the factory should be able to sell off easily. Nearness to market is crucial. So it cannot be the product. Suppose I am producing a particular kind of cloth here in Rajasthan. And the requirement for that particular textile is not there in Rajasthan, but high up in Ladakh and other extremely cold places. Then my nearness to the market will not be so. The market which I am looking for, then the transportation goods will increase, and my aim of producing something, maybe I will get labor for cheap wages. I can give very low wages to the human labor which I employ over here, but then my transportation cost will increase. So there is no point in producing a good so far away from the market where it is will be sold, that it increases the cost of the product. Now over here they have given an example of all the perishable goods which also come under the term FMCG, fast moving consumer goods. So all perishable products, even toothpaste that you use, they come under perishable, it is one of the perishable goods. They have to be consumed within a limited period of time or used within a limited period of time. So at the same time, a steady demand for finished products is important. For perishable products, it becomes important to deliver to the consumers on time. Otherwise, it will incur loss. A very huge loss. and waste of time. To rotate the production, profitable demand should be there for the product, otherwise it will lead to a loss to the industry owner. If I am producing my good sitting here and my market is 10,000 kilometers away, then what is the point in producing such a good which will not be used by the people in the nearby areas? Now here they have talked about SEZ or special economic zones. These are designated areas surveyed in India by special laws and has tax benefits to attract investments from industrialists from all over the world. Now just to bring in development to these poor backward areas. So the governments of these states or governments of these regions have come up with incentives for the people who are, and they have given them tax benefits, and they have made special laws, made it easier for other people to set up industries over there, and it provides livelihood to the people living over there and increases their standard of living. So such things are made available and people from all over the world can come up and set up their industries. Now continuous water supply. Power supply. We have already talked about accessible water source. Now power is important for any industry. Irregular power supply can hamper production in a great way and can create a problem to complete the production on time. Not only complete the production on time, but the good that you are storing. See, the meat products, the dairy products that you are storing, if your power supply is irregular, then you will not be able to store it at that temperature, the temperature required to keep it fresh. And the product will spoil and will not be consumed by the public. So it will incur a loss to the industry owner. Then we talk about the good transport network. Facility for easy and cheap transportation is important. Distance to seaport, railway and good network of roads is important factors. So if the network of roads is not good, they are potted, huge pits are there, holes are there. Okay, then what is happening, children? The movement of goods or transportation will not be smooth, thereby increasing the time for the industrial owner to reach his product or to deliver his product to the market. So all kinds of transportations are used. Water transport, rail transport, as well as road transport. So there has to be a good network of all three, depending on where the industry is located. In case of perishable products, facility of refrigerated transport has a big influence on location. For example, dairy products like curd, butter, cheese can be transported to longer distances only if refrigeration in transport is available. You know that people who can afford to, flying in exotic flowers from as far as New Zealand. Tulips are flying, being flown in from tulip and from other exotic places. Other exotic, fruit and flowers all are being exported or imported from one place to the other. Now, in the next video, we will study about the other factors which influence the location of an industry. In the meantime, I want you to go through what all we have done today, and in case you have not understood something, please note it down. We'll discuss it when the school reopens. Thank you.